ideal start for Rohit Sharma as India's home test season commences, but wasn't the ideal start to the test match. Two fine sessions for the hosts, after which rain washed out the final session of play. India standing at 202 without loss after winning the toss, and Virat Kohli deciding that he's going to have a bat and he's going to put his new opener in test cricket, Rohit Sharma, out for the first time. And he had to handle a tricky phase, Ajit Agarkar, but eventually your fellow Mumbai boy has done his own chances no harm. He's taken this opportunity. He couldn't have asked for more. 100 on the first day of the home season, after all that's being said about Rohit Sharma, the new test opener.
Not at all. I think it was written, wasn't it? That Rohit Sharma is going to come open the test innings for India, get to bat on the first day of the test. Probably the best conditions that you're going to see in this test match, and make full use of it. I mean, it was a tricky start. I think the seamers were quite good. Played well through that period, applied himself well, chose the right balls to hit at that stage, because there was something on offer for sure. A little bit of movement through the air, definitely something of the pitch. And even though it wasn't a pitch that you would get in South Africa, where consistently you can bowl in the stumps and get people out, there was always enough chances created by the South Africans, so you had to bat carefully, which he did. And then it just looked like he was batting in the nets.
Yeah, I mean, we're going to come to how Rohit Sharma went about that innings, individually break down his numbers with pace and spin. But first, let's show you a list of openers for India in Test cricket that have scored 100 in their very first innings as an opener. And he's with company that he's played and seen alongside Shikhar Dhawan, Prithvi Shaw and KL Rahul, all of whom are contenders for Rohit Sharma's spot the minute that becomes up for grabs again. But this 115 now sees him as the fourth player with a maiden Test innings century as an opener. As experienced as he is internationally, and the fact that he has done well, he even has good numbers at home, this would have been a huge sort of monkey off his back, given what was said around this personally for him.
Yeah, and to get 100. Yeah. I mean, if you look through his Test careers, there's been some quite a few starts that he's got, whether it's in India. India, his numbers are exceptional. But even abroad, when he's played away from India, he's got starts and for some reason or the other hasn't gone on to get a big one. So that would have given him a lot more satisfaction. Even though it's in India, conditions a lot friendlier, attack didn't look anything great once that new ball, they looked after the new ball well, the openers. Rabada at times was the only guy who looked like a little bit of a threat,
yeah.
But nothing apart from that. So considering all that, it was all the more important that once he got a start, he went on and got a big one, which he has batted aggressively. And like I said, not a lot of challenges in that attack. Also a very good pitch. It's a first day test match pitch, so you expect to make use of the conditions once you get through that new ball.
Yeah, we'll just have a look at Rohit Sharma's numbers against pace and spin. He's almost followed the same template as he does in ODI cricket. He took his time, had to be watchful against the new ball with Rabada and Philander, both of whom have got him enough times in test cricket before. So 42 runs scored of 70 balls versus pace in this innings, and he had Dane Pete to thank for a few of those sixes that he hit. Five in total, but 73 of 104. And that's one thing that we will see of Rohit Sharma. If he bats long enough, six hitting ability to take spinners on, put them under pressure, that sets him apart.
Yeah, I mean, certainly in India. I don't think how much spin he'll get away from India. So, look, it's not like he's uncomfortable against pace. We've seen that throughout his career. Test cricket, of course, is a different proposition. That's why I was a little bit surprised that South Africa didn't think of that third seamer option. I mean, yes, the pitches in India spin. Yes, they're on the slower side. But if you don't have real quality in your spin bowling attack, then you may as well bank on your strength and play your third seamer. I mean, someone like Ngidi sitting in that dugout, you never know when the pitch gets a little bit up and down, the ball sticks into the pitch. First morning, there was definitely something on offer for the seamers. Perhaps could have helped their cause. In my opinion, you should try and always pick your best four or five bowlers that you're going to play and try and make life difficult for the opposition that way. So, much easier to sit here and say that and in hindsight right now. But from what we've seen of their spinners, maybe it's a first day pitch, so we should reserve our judgment when they bowl on a slight or in slightly helpful conditions. they didn't look like posing Indian batsmen a lot of challenge.
Yes, Mayank Agarwal had Rohit Sharma's company and a partnership of 202, which also gives India a little bit of confidence that their opening stand hadn't necessarily been great in recent times, therefore the changes in personnel. But he's looking good for what is a maiden test 100 up for grabs, and it's perhaps a welcome innings for Mayank Agarwal as well, who had just the 150 in the four innings in the Caribbean and maybe just needs that one big score to make himself feel good too.
Yeah, and very early in his career, I mean, what, four tests before that, couple of tests in Australia where he had two really good innings when India was trying to win the series. So this will give him confidence, no matter, you know, how well you batted or how well you bowled. You know, for your confidence, you need runs or wickets in that column. So this will give him confidence. Hopefully, he can go on and get that three-figure mark, which again, you know, first test 100 for any batsman, and especially someone who's fought so hard to make or get to this Indian team heaps of runs in domestic cricket, will give him a lot of satisfaction. So he needs. Again, they'll have to start well in the morning or whenever the game does start. But the conditions are in their favour. If they don't make too many mistakes, both look on course to get a lot more runs.
Yeah, a lot more than even 100 for Mayank Agarwal if he wants it. But let's hope there is cricket on day two. And South Africa will be looking back at this day. And like Ajit points out, will they think in hindsight that perhaps this wasn't the ideal bowling attack? They did face the heat with South Africa's bowlers. Vernon Philander didn't get a wicket with a new ball. Then they're always down, looking downhill with just the two seamers. But from the 35 overs of spin, now is that just a visiting team hedging their bets, hoping that they get to bowl second and fourth on this pitch? Or are the demons of the previous series still with them? You've already said you would have liked to see a Lungengiri play, but looking at those bowlers, the 7 overs from Pete, the 5 overs from Muthuswamy, is it also looking like the pick spinners that may not pose a big question to India, even if conditions become helpful?
We'll have to wait and watch if that is the case. I mean, not being too harsh on them, it was the first day pitch.
Yes.
You don't, unless you have real quality, which Indians do have, someone like Ashwin, even on a first day pitch in India, you will see him bowl a lot differently to the South Africans. These are inexperienced South African spinners as well, so you can't be too harsh on them. So we'll have to wait and see if they can create something when the pitch does help them. But if it's a flat pitch, I think that they look very limited against a good Indian batting lineup. And that's why I felt perhaps South Africa could have banked on their strengths. And over the years, they have played seamers even when they've come to India. Okay, they've had the likes of Monty Maukel and Dale Steyn, which helps. But Ngidi is not a bad bowler. I mean, he's had quite an impact in Test cricket when he's played. So I thought they would go that way, but unfortunately they haven't, and there's some hard work to be done tomorrow for them.
Yeah, you know the feeling of a bowler who's bowled on a flat pitch on day one. You feel for the South African bowlers, I'm sure.
Yeah, I think any touring team that comes here expects that. So it's not like it's a surprise. I mean, if they'd got in a green seamer, that would have been a surprise. But so you're prepared for it. They would have been hoping they get one wicket early. That always puts a little bit more pressure, even on a good batting lineup as India, and that might have helped them create a few more chances. But at this point, they really need more than one wicket tomorrow morning.
Well, let's see how things go in the morning. Let's hope there's cricket. Thank you, Ajit Agarkar. Get your thoughts at the end of day two, on which Rohit Sharma and Mayank Agarwal will resume proceedings for India at 202 without loss. The first day of India's home season in Test cricket has most definitely gone their way. We'll be right back.